Assalamu alaikum, student. So we were discussing about cell, right? About plant cell actually. So we were discussing about some distinctive part of plant cell, and we discussed about vacuole and we discussed about chloroplast in the last lecture, right? So in the last lecture we end up with that chlorophyll, the vacuole is filled with cell sap. So today we are going to discuss about cell sap and one more distinctive component, which is starch grain. So we'll explain the composition of cell sap and then the function of cell sap and what is the role of starch grain in plant cell. Okay, so let's start with this. Cell sap is basically a liquid dissolved substances such as sugar and salts, right? So this is our vacuole, and inside the sky blue thing is the liquid, which is cell sap. And cell sap contains sugar and salt. You know that a plant doesn't move from their places to get feed themselves, right? So you have to feed them. So, and even you are not watering the plant is not gonna die for like days and days, right? Why? Because this large vacuole is filled with water and cell sap, which is dissolved sugar and salts. So plant can take up their food and take up the water from this vacuole even when you are not watering the plants, right? And there's also a function of cell sap. What is the function of cell sap? It keeps the cell firm by taking in water, right? So it is gonna take the water in and cell is going to be firm. It's like, just consider a balloon, right? So you filled a balloon with water and balloon is in its shape, and when you are going to prick it from its side, the balloon is going to be burst and shapeless, right? So similar with the plants, when the vacuole is filled with cell sap, means the water, the plant is going to be firm, right, in its shape. But if the water is going to be less or the vacuole is going to be burst, then plant will wilt, right? So the plant will die, exactly, right? Okay, then starch grains. Starch grains are basically stored food, because as I told you that plants just can't move from their places to get their food. So we have to feed them. And if we are not going to feed them, the plant are going to be wilt. So for their own benefit, plants stored their food in form of starch grain. These are tiny, tiny little starch grains. These are looking like big starch grains, but these are not very big. This is a microscopic view and you cannot see this starch grain with your naked eyes, right? So these are very tiny, tiny like a pencil dot, okay? So they are just spread in the cytoplasm of the plant cell, and whenever plant needs food, the plant is going to get the food by breaking down the starch grains, right? We were left with just one distinctive part, which is cell wall, right? Because we were talking about some distinctive part and we talked about chloroplast, we talked about vacuole, we talked about starch grain, we talked about cell sap. Now the last thing which is very distinctive in the plant cell is its cell wall, right? So let's describe the structure and function of cell wall, and then at the end we'll draw the draw and label the diagram of the plant cell. So you have to draw the diagram of the plant cell with me, okay? Right? Are you ready to draw it? Good. So this is the simplest diagram of the plant cell. And you can see this, there is an outer lining, then a cell membrane, two layers, this one black layer and this other black layer. This is the cell wall, okay? And cell wall is there to, cell wall is like a wall of bricks, right? Just consider a swimming pool. If there is no wall around the water is going to be out, exactly split out, because there is no wall. But the wall of the swimming pool just don't get the water out of that boundary. Similar function is of cell wall. Cell wall supports the plant and make it in its shape, right? So plant just can't wilt, right? Also, there is another function of cell wall there. Did you notice that cell wall is not present in animal cell? Right. Then why it just present in plant cell? So the answer is, plant can not move, but animal can move. Animal can move for shelter. Animal can move in, if you feel like cold, you can move to a warmer place. If you feel like warm, you can move to a colder place, right? but plant can't move. They have to withstand with the heat, they have to withstand with the cold, they have to withstand with the thunderstorms or other hailstorms, right? So that's why cell wall is there in plant, to protect the plant from all these thunderstorms, okay? Because plant can't move, they can't just go to find out a shelter. Cell wall is basically made up of thick layer of cellulose. This is the structure of cellulose, okay? So these are some pipes like things of cellulose, and they are very, very tightly bound in the cell wall, and that's why cell wall is so strong, right? And again, you just don't need to just draw the diagram of this cellulose thing. I just show the diagram so you can have a clear idea about how cellulose look like and why cell wall is so strong, because there are very, very like timber-like cellulose are there to make it very, very strong, okay? So you have to make the cell wall, you have to make the plant cell. And yes, I told you in the last lecture that you are going to have an assignment. So this is your assignment. You have to list down the main distinctive parts of the cell. We already have in our mind, right? Good. Then we have to write the properties and function of chloroplast. I already told you about that, the green pigment, the chlorophyll, photosynthesis, right? Good enough. Describe the role of vacuole in plant cell. I told you about that, the big vacuole, the huge vacuole, right? Then write the name of the substance found in vacuole. How the cell sap keeps the cell firm. I told you about that by taking in water, in which stored food is found in the cytoplasm. So this is your assignment. Good luck for your assignment. I hope you'll do it, and you are going to learn about the plant cell as well, right? And you are going to draw the plant cell very, very neat and tidy. I'll see you in the next lecture. Meanwhile, just do your assignment, do study, and stay safe. Allah Hafiz.